You are welcome to Math Demystified.
In this lesson, I'm introducing us to bearing. There are two types of bearing. We have the three-figure bearing and we have the compass bearing. I will start with the three-figure bearing. In three-figure bearing, we take reading from the north. From the north, and you read the angle in a clockwise direction. And all your angles are written in three-figure. For example, 3 degrees will be written as. And if you want to write 27, it will be written as 027 degrees. Let's start by representing some directions on the board. So if you have 60 degrees, this bearing of 60 degrees, you want to represent it, you represent like this. You move from here, from the north, between this and this is 90 degrees. Between here and here is 190 degrees, 190, 190, making 360. So this is 180 from here to this place. Is 270 from here to this place is 360. So we want to represent 60 degrees. Since from here to here is 90, 60 is in between 0 and 90. So I move to this direction, something like this, and I'll stop. This is my 60 degree. If I want to represent 120 degrees, I start from the north and I move past 90 somewhere here because this is 180 and I'll draw. This whole angle here is angle 120 degrees. I want to learn that this can be broken down to 90 plus 30. If I want to represent angle 210, for instance, it will be done like this. From the north, you move past 90, another 90, that's 180. If I get to this place, it's 270. So I stop somewhere around here. And that will be the whole of this angle is angle 210, which you can break into 90, another 90, 180. What do you have more to make the 210? 180, so that will be 30, so this space is 30 degrees. And if I have another one, say I have angle 330, for instance. 330, for instance, so I move from here. It's 90, 180, 270. If I get to this space, it's 360, so somewhere here. So the whole of this angle is 330 degrees. So this is 90, another 90, another 90. So that's 270. So if I have 270, what else do I have more to make it 330? This is 60 degrees. Next, let's see how to link from one point to another point. Let's look at this question. If the bearing of A from B is 060 degrees, what is the bearing of B from A? Now, one thing I want you to consider here is this word from. You start drawing from the letter after the word from. In this case, the letter is B. If I tell you, I came to this place from home, I want to trace my movement, it will start from my home. So the bearing of A from B means that I'm starting from B. So bearing, I told us that bearing means direction. So the direction of A from B, that means if I'm in B and I want to look at A, at what direction will I be looking at A? They said it is 60. So we quickly locate that. Let's see. So that will be this might be my starting point. So if I'm in B, I'm looking at A at 60. I said we'll start from the north and we move clockwise. So this is my 60 degrees and this is my A. The question says, what is the bearing of B from A? The question is now saying, if I now decide to look at B when I'm in A, at what direction will I be looking at B? So we start from here, from the north again, and you keep drawing this angle till you get to the line joining the two points, and this is the line, you stop there. So this place is 90, this is another 90, we need this angle. And there's something you must learn in this topic. This line you see and this line are parallel to themselves. If they are parallel, this angle here is alternate to this angle. So this place is 60. So the bearing of B from A will now be 90 plus another 90 plus 60 degrees. And that will give us 180 plus 60. And that will be 240 degrees. It's as simple as that. Now let's look at the next question. If the bearing of X from Y is 120 degrees, what is the bearing of Y from X? Now looking at this, this is our starting point, the letter after the word from. So we are told that the bearing is 120 degrees. So I'll draw. From here, this is my Y, and I'm moving from here, going 120 degrees. This 90, 120 is somewhere here. And this one becomes my X. So the whole of this is 120 degrees. And the bearing of Y from X, if I'm in X now, and I want to look at the direction of Y, I move from here, and I'll go to where the line joining the two points are. This is 90 here, this is another 90, this is another 90, I have 270, I need this angle. Come back here, this is 90, so if from here to here is 120, and this is 90, here is 30. This 30 is alternate to this angle I'm looking for, so this is 30. I have 90 plus 90, 180, that's plus 90, 270, plus 30, 300. So the bearing will be 300. That means the bearing of Y from X is 300. The next question says, if the bearing of W from X is 210. So let's start drawing from the letter after the word from. So I'm starting from X. So I'm going this way. This is my X. My total is 210. I move from here. This is 90. 180, 210 is somewhere here. So the whole of this is 210. Then this is where my W is. What is the bearing of X from W? If I'm in W and I'm looking at X, half of the north, this is just what I'm looking for. So let's break this 210 into pieces. We have 90, we have another 90, making 180, here will be 30. That simply means this angle also is 30. So the answer will be 030 degree. If you write your answer as 30 degree, you will be wrong, because it is called three figure bearing. All your answers must be written in three figure. Now to the next question. If the bearing of T from W is 300, quickly let's move on. This is W, so I'm starting from W, my W, and 300, from here I have 90, 180, 270, then 300. So W, and this is my T. What is the bearing of W from T? If I'm here in T, and I'm looking at W, so I'm looking at that with this direction. So let's fix it. So from here, this is 300. If it is 300, this is 90 plus 190, 180 plus 190, 270. What is left to make 300? 30. So here is 30. So So if this is 30, this is also 30 alternate angle, and you know this is 90 degrees. So the answer to this question will now be 90 degrees plus 30 degrees, and that will be 120 degrees. So the bearing of W from T is 120 degrees. This is the basics, and this is how to fit three figure bearing. You take your reading from the north and you move in a clockwise direction. And do not forget that your answers must be written in three figures. Let's move to compass bearing. In compass bearing, unlike the three figure bearing, you take reading from both the north and the south towards the east and towards the west. See, towards the east, towards the west. So, this is my east, this is my west, this is the east, and this is the west. So if I'm told that somebody moves north 30 degree east, this is the 30 degree east, north 30 degree east, this is north 30 degrees west, south 30 degrees east, and south 30 degrees west. That's how to represent it. Now, if you look at this representation, you discover that there is no angle formed here. There's no angle formed here. All our angles are attached to the north or south, so attached to the y-axis. No angle is attached to the x-axis. And in this bearing, all the angles are acute angles, meaning that they are between 0 and 90 degrees in this bearing. If you are asked to represent north 70 degree east, you draw your cardinal point, you move from the north, because this is north 70 degree, you are going towards east, and from here to here is 90 degrees, so you just move close to the 90 degree, you stop. So this is your east, and this is your north, this is your 70 degrees. If you are asked to represent north 25 degree west, you draw the same cardinal point. This is your north, you are going towards west 25 degrees. So you move 25 degrees, and this is your west. And I'm asked to represent south 70 degree west. I'll start from the south and move towards west 70 degrees. So this is 70 degree west. So I'm also asked to represent south 25 degrees east. I draw my cardinal point, so from the south, I move towards the east 25 degrees, and this is 25 degrees, and this is my east. That's how to represent your angles in a compass bearing. Now, let's see some conversion. I want to convert from one bearing to the other. If I have north 60 degree east, I want to represent it as a three-figure bearing. What will it be? Let's see what it will be. This is north, 60 degrees east, going this way, 60 degrees east is 60 degrees. What will it be in three-figure? In three-figure, we always start our movement from the north and we move clockwise. So this looks like what it should be from the north clockwise. So in three figure, it will be 0, 6, 0 degree. If I'm given north 60 degree west, now I want to convert to three figure. Let's see what it will be like. This north, I'm moving 60 degrees towards west. 60 degrees. If I want to represent this as a three figure, I'm supposed to move from the north and move till I get to the line, joining any 2 points I have. So, and this is how it's going to be in three figure, where this will now be 90, plus another 90, plus another 90. If this is 60 in this quadrant, here will be 30. So that means that in three figure, it will be 270 plus 30, which happens to be 300 degrees. So I'm asked to convert south 60 degrees east as three figure. What will it be? Let's see. South, I'm moving towards east, 60 degrees. So this is 60 degrees, and this is my east. If I'm going to convert to three figure, I'm supposed to move from the north to wherever the line is. So if you look at this, this is 90 degrees. In this quadrant, it should be 90, this is 60, so this is 30. That means this is 120 degrees, and that is what it will be if I do my conversion. And finally, if I have south 60 degrees west, to convert to three figure, what do I do? You have this, and this is my south. I'm going towards west, 60 degrees. 60 degrees here, and this is west. Let's convert to three figure. You know, it's supposed to come from here and move to where this line is. So the angle is supposed to be like this. So in that case, this is 90. This is another 90. And the last angle here is 60 degrees, if you look at it properly. So what will it be? That will be 180 plus 60, which happens to be 240 degrees. So if you are actually given something like 240 and you want to take it to compass bearing, you take your 240, break it down into quadrants, knowing that this angle, this line you have is towards south. So that will be south west, so you can pick the angle you want from there. Learn to be able to convert from either the compass to three figure or three figure to the compass bearing.
If you enjoyed our teaching, please click like and feel free to share our link with your friends. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel so that you can get notifications of our subsequent videos.